Hey guys, what's up and welcome back to my channel. I decided that today I would keep this video a little bit more on the casual side because I think my allergies are kind of acting up, so my eye is really bothering me and I don't want to put anything in that area, so I'm just gonna be like a normal everyday person. Also, I just wanted to address my background situation a little bit. My usual setup is like literally right there, but I am kind of moving things around and it's not quite ready yet. So I am just filming against this blank wall and I think it'll help me show you guys the different things that I got a little bit better. So for those of you who are not familiar with Trunk Club, I will leave links down in the description box below. And I'll also leave a link up in the cards that you can click on for the last Trunk Club video that I filmed and posted. There's also a code that I will leave in the description box as well in case you want to try out Trunk Club for the very first time. If you use the link in my description box, you can get some credit off and then I will get credit off one of my future Trunk Club purchases. So thank you in advance if you happen to use that link. No pressure at all, it's totally up to you. So long story short with Trunk Club, this is not something that I do on a regular basis, but I have been really trying to update my wardrobe. Basically what happens is a stylist who works for Trunk Club puts together a variety of items into a box, so it can be, you know, tops, jackets, pants, shoes, accessories, just depending on what you tell them your preferences are. They also ask you about like colors, sizes, and style preferences that you might be looking for. And there's a chat function that you can have like a dialogue with a stylist and tell them like some specific stuff in case there is something in particular you're looking for. So in this box, I left it up to the stylist a little bit more. So usually I'll give a little bit more input and feedback and kind of like tell them what my preferences are, but the boxes that I've been getting have been maybe a little bit too specific or stuff I already have in my closet. And I'm not just trying to, you know, have like 20 pairs of black pants, even though I probably have like 10 pairs of black pants at this point. So clearly I'm trying to get away from that and vary things up. I did recently just donate a bunch of my clothes to a nonprofit organization that my friend was teaming up with, and they were honestly clothes that I hadn't worn in like 2 years or something like that. I do also have some fairly new things that I haven't worn, still have tags on, or maybe I wore it once or twice and that's it, and I have been posting those things onto Poshmark. So my closet has sort of been getting smaller and smaller is basically what I'm trying to say. But also in the past couple of years, I have just generally been feeling like I have a hard time finding clothes that I like nowadays. There are things that I'll find here and there, but I keep going back to the same stores, same styles, and I don't really have as much variety as I used to have like quite a while ago. That's definitely one of the reasons why I decided that I wanted to do Trunk Club more frequently, I guess. I don't think this is something I'm gonna be doing a ton, but the good thing is that you can send back clothes that you don't wanna keep, so it's not like I'm keeping all of this stuff all the time. There's a few days that you have to try everything on and then send back what you don't like, and they'll only charge you for the things that you'll keep. So in every box that I get, I do think about which items I actually do wanna keep, and I'm not just trying to like keep a bunch of stuff unnecessarily. Okay, so that was clearly a lot of talking, and I'm gonna get right into the video now. So in every box, they send you a list of all of the items that will be in the box that you receive, which is right here. In this box, I noticed they mentioned 10, it says 10 items up at the top of this, but on the app where they show you the different styles and give you like style recommendations and what goes with what, I noticed that I didn't have 10 things and it looked a little bit less than the preview that I had gotten. So I messaged them and asked them about that, and they said that while they were packing the box, some of the items were sold out because there's a lot of sales going on right now. Trunk Club is a Nordstrom company, so I'm guessing that, you know, some of those items were maybe like on Black Friday sales or Cyber Monday sales with Nordstrom, and by the time they were putting this box together for me, they didn't have my size or that item anymore. So I've already filmed the try-on parts of this video, so as I'm talking through the items, I will show you what those things look like. One thing that I'll be doing a little bit different in this video is because I tried everything on first instead of unboxing it. I already know what I like, what I don't like, what I'm gonna keep, so I'll be able to tell that to you in this video rather than putting a bunch of text on the screen like I have been in the past couple of Trunk Club videos. So the first item on the list is this pair of boots. It's by Blondo. It's their Sienna Waterproof Bootie. This is the color Dark Taupe. And it's in a size 5.5. So I do have another pair of Blondo boots. I actually purchased them during the Nordstrom anniversary sale, and they are in my haul video, which I will link up in the cards and down below if you want to check that video out. That pair that I got during the Nordstrom anniversary, so it's actually my second pair of Blondos. I do want to keep these, but I asked them about exchanging for the size. So my other pair of Blondos are in a size 6. Those are flat. This one has a little bit of a heel. When I try it on, it feels just a little bit too tight. I'm not sure if these will stretch out, but you know, if I wear like thicker socks, these would definitely feel quite a bit tighter. Like I should probably go up a half a size. So I asked them about exchanging it, and so that's the request that I put in to the Trunk Club app, and they will be sending me a size 6 instead in the same boot, same color. This exact one, 5.5, is actually now sold out on the website, so just wanted to mention that. Once they get these back for me, I guess it'll be back in stock. They'll have one pair. But I did check with them that if the 6 doesn't fit, I would be able to return that. But yeah, I think these are a great neutral color. I definitely like kind of like this taupey brown. I don't really wear a lot of brown. Definitely not like a regular like medium brown. But yeah, these are really comfortable. I know not everybody likes a big heel like this, but for me, I mean, this is something that I would probably wear to work and I'd wanna be comfortable in it for a long period of time. So this heel is really big and it'll definitely help with the comfort factor. So I'm looking forward to getting in the size 6. Oh, and by the way, I believe the regular price on those boots are $99.95, but I think they're on sale for like $69.95 or something like that. So this next item here is a open front sweater blazer by J. Crew. This is in the size extra, extra small. The color is charcoal and it is $79. So this one is also on sale. I think regular price it is $158, but this is what this blazer sweater looks like. I actually feel like, you know, I like the style. I kind of wish that the color of the design on the camera looks a little bit darker than in person on the screen that I'm looking at. In person, it looks a little bit like a dark brownish gray, and I kind of wish it was like a dark charcoal color. I do like the concept of a sweater blazer. I felt like it was really comfortable when I tried it on. The sleeves were surprisingly shorter than I thought they were going to be. They were not covering my hands like sleeves of sweaters normally are. I like the look of it, but the thing that I didn't like about it is that I tried it on with the black top that I got in this box as well, and it did leave quite a bit of lint behind on the black top. And that's basically what pretty much put me on the fence on if this is a blazer that I would actually like and wear. I didn't feel like I absolutely loved it, which is the reason why I'm going to be sending it back. But if this is something that you're looking for and you really like this style and color, I would say to check it out because it is pretty comfortable. It has a good weight to it. You guys have been watching my channel for a while now. You know I live in a hot climate year round. So don't take it from me. I couldn't tell you if you could wear this out in like 40 or 30 degree weather. I highly doubt it. But I mean, if you're someone who can tolerate cold and just want something a little bit on the lighter side, this might be for you. For me personally, I'm someone who just gets cold a lot, and I feel like this would help me a lot in a like air conditioned office. So the next item I have here is the Cameron Four Seasons crop pants from J. Crew. It's in the color dark spruce and the size 0. These pants are $89.50 and they were not on sale at the point in which I got them in, which is totally okay. But I actually really like the color of these pants. It's definitely different from anything else that I have currently. I have a lot of black pants, like I mentioned, which I'm trying to get away from. And for the most part, these pants fit okay. Like it felt pretty good. It felt fine from like the waist, the hips, and through the thigh to the top of the knee. But based on the picture that I saw, they're supposed to be more of like a slimmer fitting ankle pant, and that's not the way that it really fits on me. I feel like this looks more like a straight leg sort of pant, which is not really the leg style that I typically go for. So I normally like a more tapered fit through the calf, and honestly my leg is pretty skinny in that area, which is why I like that style a little bit better. It doesn't look as baggy on me. So that's the reason why I would send these back. If they fit me better, I think I would keep them because I like the color. They feel really good on and I feel like they look flattering. So the next item that I received are the small endless hoop earrings by Halogen. They're in a gold color and it's one size. These are $19. I am going to keep them in the wrapper though because I'm going to be sending it back, but this is what they look like. Just a pretty basic like standard gold hoop. The reason why I'm sending these back is because I do have some metal sensitivity, so I can't just wear any old jewelry jewelry, and I have a feeling this would be one that I would have a reaction to. But if you're looking for some like pretty plain gold colored hoops, I think this would be a good option at a pretty reasonable price point at $19. All right, so this is the item that I actually tried on under the blazer. It is a flutter sleeve sweater by Halogen. It's in an extra small, and this is $35.40. I think that is also the sale price that's listed on the sheet that I have. And overall, I felt like this was a pretty nice top. Like, it felt really good on. I think it was flattering. The only thing for me is that the flutter sleeve area, like the sleeve detail, it was a little bit too much for me. I felt like it came up a little bit too high. I felt like this was a really great top for work, but because, like I mentioned, I do get cold in the office, I typically throw like a cardigan or some other sweater over whatever top I'm wearing, and I felt like this would just cause the shoulder area to be a little bit more bulky looking than it needed to be. So that's the reason why I will be sending it back. But if you're someone who is comfortable wearing like a sleeveless top, maybe this is something that you could wear in spring or summer when it's, you know, not as cold. Or if you're someone who can tolerate office air conditioning, this might be a good top for you, but I didn't think that it would work out for me. I did like how it looked though. Another jacket that I received in my box is this tweed jacket by Halogen. It's in an extra, extra small petite in the color black. And this one is $74.50. It was also on sale, and I can't remember what the regular price was. But this jacket I thought was pretty cute. I did like the gold button details at the front, and I don't own any tweed jackets. I don't really actually own many jackets in general. But I thought that this would be a great addition to my jacket collection. It doesn't have any shoulder pads or anything like that. It fits pretty well. My honest feedback though, and this is just my personal opinion, is for me, the tweed like frayed edges is a little bit too much for me. I think if this was maybe like half the length or something like that, I feel like I would have been okay with that. I am somebody who likes a little bit more like clean lines, and so, you know, that's the reason why I'm sending this back. But I did like the way that it looked on. I generally do like the look of tweed jackets. Maybe it's one of those things where I like it better on other people than myself, but I do appreciate that the stylist sent this over. It's just not something that I'll be keeping. Another pair of earrings that I received in my box are these from Nadri. They're the Camilla Imitation Pearl Cluster Earrings, also in the color gold. So these were $40, and for the same reason I'm sending back the gold hoops, I'll be sending these back. I'm pretty sure this is something that I would have a reaction to, but I think they're really cute. Sorry, this one's upside down. If I weren't allergic to it, I would definitely keep these. I think this would be a great pair of earrings to wear during the holiday season or even into the office like year round. Yeah, they're super cute. I just wish I wasn't so sensitive when it came to earrings. So the last item that I received in my box is a pack of face masks. This is a 3-pack by Lele Sadoi. I'm not sure if I'm saying that correctly. This is the first time that I'm seeing this brand. It's in the color Cloud, which is really, I mean, assorted. It came in a pack of three and it's one size. So this is actually an item that I selected. They give you some options, and even when they're showing you the other items, they'll let you choose like different sizes or colors if there are other options. But I specifically chose this one because while I do have a lot of face masks, like I'm sure a lot of us are collecting or building our face mask collections, I did kind of feel like I needed some that were a little bit more dressy looking or appropriate for work. And honestly, I haven't really gone out very much except for things that I need to do, like grocery store shopping, a couple of returns at the mall. I think I've only done that twice in the past several months. But you know, if at some point in the future we do have to occasionally wear masks, but maybe not as much as today, and I do end up having to go somewhere that's a little bit nicer, I did want some masks that would match more of my outfits and kind of, you know, be a little bit more versatile and look presentable. A lot of the masks that I have, they're great. I've definitely supported some local businesses with buying masks, but most of the masks that I currently have are homemade, and they're from like any kind of fabric. Like, they're very random. So I did kind of feel like I wanted to get a few just in case I do need to be a little bit less casual with my mask wearing situation. All right, you guys, thank you so much for watching this casual trunk club haul kind of try on video. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know down in the comments below if you have any questions about trunk club. Which of these items would you have kept? I definitely want to learn more about your guys' style, and if you have any other style tips for me or places where I might be able to find some great items. I'm mostly looking for like tops and things that are like work to weekend kind of stuff, please leave that for me down in the comments below. I would really appreciate any of your suggestions in helping to rebuild my wardrobe because I definitely want to change it up and add more variety. If you enjoyed watching this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe to my channel for my upcoming videos. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!